CEO of Kels Entertainment. I'm currently a promoter. I've been promoting almost 4 years now. I'm one of the hottest promoters in Miami and Broward. I do basically everything. So they call me best of the both worlds. Shit, you can call me the king. Let's go. Being a promoter is a hard job. A lot of people think that it's easy, but this shit ain't easy. I gotta do all type of things that I don't wanna do, even when it comes down to taking pictures with people that I give about. But I still gotta do it. I gotta stay humble. I gotta make sure bottle's right. I gotta make sure my customer service on point. Make sure my people right so they can continue to come party with me. So it's like even when I'm feeling down or even when I'm going through whatever I'm going through, I still gotta be happy to the public eye. Me and Nico been on and off really not talking to each other for about a year. We was once best friends. So to go from being best friends to not talking at all basically for a whole year, it leaves me puzzled, like I'm blank. I don't know how to feel. I'm surprised she even here. Why are you here? I really just kind of miss her a little bit. So I'm going to reach out to her and see if we could patch things up and see what went wrong.
Why you don't put your pictures up? All this thickness.
Because he full of shit. That's my Instagram. My Facebook friend, Kels.
Oh, okay. So you be seeing the posts.
That's I good. Do. I look at everything.
You
have
one night?
Y'all fun?
I'm going to go get her drunk ass in the club.
Okay, go in the club and turn up. We finna come in there. We got to talk some business real quick.
So I'm going to talk to my partner, Doug, the head of CEO Promotions, and see what we can come up with to make this night really pop.
Double. Got this shit like. But the night doing good though.
Yeah. We're trying to do a little something, man. We just gotta get it. We gotta get it going, man. Gotta get it going, man.
So what are the ideas you may have, like as far as like what you think we should do? That'll be a little different. We in the nicest strip club. One of the nicest strip clubs down here, Rick.
We out here talking about all the old people that we done already bought, or people that he done already did before I joined the night. And it's like, that's the past. I'm thinking about the future. What can we do now? We did.
But the thing about it is like, we packing this shit out though, bro. Like, I was thinking like, I was gonna holler at KLD to see like, what else they got because we packing it.
Yeah, cause when we did, the Joe Buttons for our 1 year anniversary, man, this shit was on dumbass swole.
Know what I'm saying? So a lot of people had to go to another club.
Yeah.
Because you couldn't fit no more. Know what I'm saying? Like, you ain't never think about, like, moving the Wednesday party to another club that can hold more people?
Nah, but it's kind of loud where we at, though. You know what I'm saying? Because we could fit a nice little amount because we ain't even really broke open the little lounge bar back there in that back. And that lounge bar hold about 200-300. So all
that. I ain't really that big when people be telling me what they could do and what they want to do and all that. I'm going to just let his actions speak for it. So he's saying things that we about to make happen. I guess I'm going to just see what happens.
Appreciate it, Remy.
So I did.
Hey, I'm Max, CEO of Maximum Sport Photography. I do photography and videography throughout the state of Florida. But now I think it's about time for me to take this act on the road. I mean, I've been here for all my life. I'm trying to go different places that I ain't never seen before. Capture different shots that I never shot before. So, I mean, all this is kind of making me feel like, you know, I'm not going nowhere. Time to take my stuff to the next level. So some people may know me as being the house photographer at a local club called CULMER. Yeah, it's a strip joint, but don't get it twisted. You done had everybody who's anybody come up in there. From the Jeezys, the P. Diddy's, the Yo Gotti, Jim Jones, I mean, even more. What? Okay. You know, sometimes at the end of the night, you know, I get a little lonely when I'm leaving the club. And, you know, I got nobody I could call home to. I'm single. So, you know, sometimes I got to go on my little black book and see what's up. See who I can hit up at the end of the night. You know what I mean?
All right, I'm be there in like 5-10 minutes. I'm in the car right now.
My name is Katrina. I'm a hairstylist by day and a promoter by night. A jack of all trades. I do whatever it takes to pay the bills. I've been a hairdresser for the last 20 years. I do what I need to do to make my ends meet. It's something that I love to do. Doing hair is like basically getting paid for free for doing whatever you gotta do to make somebody look good. And it's like just going to help a friend. At the end of the day, I do promotions at night because I know it takes a multitude of things to make it happen. At the end of the day, closed mouths don't get fed, so I do whatever it needs to do to make it happen.
Hi, my name is Tutu. Most people know me by Lady Tutu. I'm a female entertainer slash model. I've been dancing for a couple of years now. I do birthday parties, bachelor parties. I have some friends, you know, and I do some modeling.
Okay. I mean, before, you know, we can't get it promoted and all that, but actually out seeing it in full effect, yeah.
Nice one. Sure, really nice. Well, I think I need me a drink. It looks like the night is going to go pretty well. They got a decent crowd. So as I'm walking around the crowd, I spot Max in the building. Max be everywhere. Every time I go somewhere, I see him. So I'm gonna go over here and holler at her and see what she up to.
So tonight, you know, I'm at Club Vault. Some local promoters called me to come down and take some pictures of the crowd. So you know, I'm about to go check it out, see what's up. I'm in there and I'm like, whoa, I see Tutu. She not Tutu. I've been knowing her for like a little minute, you know. But you know, it ain't been nothing like I've been trying to get at her, nothing. But you know, sometimes I look at her and be like, I can get that. I mean, don't get me wrong, she's a nice girl and everything, but she kind of be leading your girl on, you know what I'm saying? With a little smiles, a little winking on the face and all that other stuff like that. So, you know, I'm going to try to stay back from her a little bit, but I'm telling you, she pressing on to me.
Shit, you know, the rain is still real.
always want to go home with me. I don't know. She making it kind of hard. I be looking at her and I love her dress. So I don't know. But I'm trying to keep it cute.
Watch the game, and you're going to get something to eat wherever you go. So do not do that.
She support me. She dealt with me mentally, physically, whatever I need, she's there. So that's my heart, my backbone.
I was out all day. I've been up this morning. My hair is so nappy. My natural hair is so nappy. I think I'm going to be permanent.
You know your hair nappy.
Is your
forehead
big
as fuck too?
Why
do
you fix this?
Me and Kel, we haven't spoken about
headache. Kel hit me up. What happened?
I mean, shit, it's been a while now, so why not? See what she
gotta
say.
It all went down when I didn't go to her fucking birthday party. Instead of her coming to me like a fucking woman, she's assumed and she listened to everybody else. Which her party, I was sick, so I couldn't make it. Any other event that she does, I'll be there.
Gotta be, you better off. Don't hold no grudges. Stop your blessings, so see what she got to say. Maybe we go from there.
I really don't want to, but she said just go just to see what she got to say, so I'm like, whatever. I'll go.
If it ain't nothing positive, and we just keep it moving. I mean, y'all was always friends before, yeah, you know? So.
There's a misunderstanding.
Pretty much. Too much is going on at the time, so. Bypass it. It's been what? Two years.
Some shit like that.
Yeah, almost 2 years.
She's
dead.
Yo, man, that shit crazy, bro. I don't know what to tell you.
What's up, man? My name's C. I'm from Fort Lauderdale. They call me Him Lady. I drive a forklift. I work in a warehouse. I always keep a bad one, you know?
Damn, but
What's up, man?
I'm gonna call you back, quick. What's up, bro?
Man, your ass crazy, bro. What happened to your ass last night? They told me something. Like, something was up with you, man. What the fuck you was doing?
So, I ain't seen my homie C in a little minute. I mean, I'm going over there to holler at her because it's like I heard some little stuff that happened last night in the strip club. And saying she on top of the stage beating on girls and stuff, man. I gotta see what's up.
Telling how good me and Newt was doing whatever, right?
Yeah.
Failure. I just told you the other day, though. That's the thing about it.
Bruh, this Newt situation last night, bruh. That's what I want to know, what happened last night.
Bruh.
Because I had to rush over here for this one.
I said I'm finna go to office, just chill, vibe.
Is that what you told me earlier?
Yeah, like, I was gonna chill and vibe solo, you feel me? None of my dogs ain't want to go fuck that. Ain't no me, I be ready to slide. So I went. possibly new ex-girlfriend and the hoe she was talking to, me and her broke up for them 6 months. And I'm like,
yeah. Something ain't look right.
Then I see her homegirl Avalon dancing. And I said, so Nuke gotta be here.
It made me feel better when I'm beating ass. But then the next day I think about it like, damn, man. Baby, you getting too old for this, see? Tighten up. And I try to do better. But then I have niggas and fuck niggas around me who made me do worse.
Yeah.
Let me just clarify. At the end of the day, me and Nuke ain't in a relationship. We're just getting to... We're just getting back. We were trying to make it work. You feel me? But she too caught up on this Jessica situation. And all this other stuff.
She's still on that shit.
Yeah, she's still on that shit. But that shit old. Yeah, I did what I did, but that shit was old as fuck. At the end of the day, you feel me? You're like literally old. I had been broken up by our relationship for 2 months. We just fresh. You feel me?
Yeah, yeah.
I ain't justifying. I did what I did and it was wrong. But I'm doing better.
That shit was gonna happen, man.
You did.
I don't know. I be turned up. I be low key, but it's just like. These niggas be trying to be like, I ain't about that life. I'm really about that life.
So I'm on the stage. This hoe, they call them, that's some bullshit. Right when this shit happened, they call them hoes on the stage. Yeah. They ain't no hoes, whatever, but you know how I talk. You know, they call them on the stage. Yeah. You feel me? And they went to dancing. She gave me eye contact. And I felt like she was saying, nah, 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 boo, boo. Bro, I'm telling you.
That Hennessy talking.
Bro, that was that Henny. That was probably my homegirl Crystal. Bitch, I don't know. Bitch, what I did, fool. I'm in the chair like, I'm tripping. I don't know the fuck. I ain't on no drugs.
You telling me this story and I'm thinking like, see, it's crazy. How you get on stage, fight a girl in front of all these people? Like, telling you, man, love will do it to you. That's why I ain't in love with nobody.
Bro, I had so many fucking hoes. You feel me? Before we started talking, she want everybody to think we together, so bitch, act like it.
Yeah.
Bro, anyways, I took that last shot. I looked up again, and that hoe was looking at me. She did some shit, bro.
Charged.
Bro, I ran on stage. She ain't even know it, boy. I know I caught off guard, bro. That was some. I ain't gonna lie,
you jumped on stage in front of everybody.
I feel embarrassed as hell. Yeah, I jumped on stage, bro.
What security did?
It was two securities right there. I ran right. I was so fast. My fat ass 180 solid. I ran, but I had quit, bro. I stood on stage. I had it swung. Boom. She fell to the ground or whatever. You feel me? Yeah, I hit her. I was mad. Ain't gonna lie. I hit her. Then she started attacking me, and she attacking me. I just like grabbed her hell, you feel me? Because I ain't want to fight no more. I just and yoked her to the ground, like chill.
So all who's on the stage,
bro. Spotlight on me, bitch. Swear to God, man. The lights on, they were dancing, bitch. The sun, the DJ had to stop the song. He's like, oh shit. Feel me?
Oh, you crazy,
bro. I know, man. I know. I probably ain't gonna better come back to the club no more, bro. So security came. He that nigga had me choked, feet dangling off the ground, bitch. I kicked that hoe right in the stomach. Boom. Bam. I was mad, bro. I was doing some petty shit. Like, I gotta stop drinking.
You don't
want
to be with her no more.
Make a long story short, man. I do, but.
You just told me that you were thinking about going to another.
No, yeah. Exactly. You feel me? I ain't gonna lie to you, bro. I wanted to marry her. I was ready. Feel me? But I think she ain't ready because she too caught up. She think I finna fuck back with Jay. But if she only knew, boy, that shit is like a closed chapter.
I mean, after this conversation, I just realized that she need to slow down, man. I mean, we getting older. And all this, doing this reckless stuff, probably end up going to jail behind some female. That's for the birds.
As far as my nighttime hustle is concerned, I promote for Cloud9 Lounge on Saturday nights. But recently I've been having a problem with my DJ that needs to be addressed ASAP.
We need to talk about some advertisement and what we gonna do to kill the vines in Tokyo.
But it's hard to address somebody that's so fake and phony. I got such a problem with dealing with females that look and dress like men but have bitch tendencies.
We need to make Cloud9 jump more often each and every Saturday night. Now that Scissor Her is gone, I need to know that you are committed to what we got going on.
I'm 100% committed. Mm-hmm. We're gonna go in, we're gonna go hard.
And we're gonna do what we need to do to shut Tokyo Blue down and any other club that's going on.
Yes. She's always saying that she's gonna do this and she's gonna do that, but at the end of the day, she's not loyal to Fat Cat Productions.
This our first week back. We ain't did much promotion at all. And we already like packed out the building. We had them coming from over there to over here.
Even
so, trust. We got this. this. We got this. We gonna
just make sure that we got this, because if we don't got this, we gonna shut this shit down.
No.
One way or the other.
It's got it.
Okay.
Trust me. It has got it. Believe that. Give me some. Look.
Get your ass out of my face.
Chest.
With that being said, I have to deal with her accordingly.
So me and Kels ain't been talking to each other for a little minute. I mean, we text each other every now and then, here and now. But I've been noticing that it's like, you know, we ain't like how we used to be. You know what I'm saying? So I, you know, we hit her up. You know what I'm saying? We talk, we decide to meet up and let's talk things out and see what's going on.
Max don't understand how serious this shit is. This shit is like deeper than rap type serious. I feel as though, I understand that they was friends before me. That's cool with me. And then me and you became friends. But then me and you took it from being regular friends to best friends. More like you my dog, I tell you everything, you tell me everything type relationship. And then now you go and you double back after you knew what me and C. Weezy went through prior. So it's like you go back and you double back, and now I see y'all posting up pictures all the time and y'all hanging out all the time. I'm not that type of nigga. I'm not gonna come up to you and ask you to stop being that person friend. But I'm going back up. I'm going back off. I gotta back off. I gotta protect myself. I'm not gonna be sitting up here telling you every fucking thing about me and you friends with my number one enemy. And I don't got a lot of enemies. That's one motherfucker that I don't like.
Tell me that you've been backing off and ain't been talking to me because you seen me hanging with C. Now what you and her got going on is what you and her got going on. It has nothing to do with me. At the end of the day, if you loyal to me and we supposed to be friends like how you say we friends, it shouldn't even matter. And then you either check it or disrespect it.
Away about that shit, and Max acting like she really don't understand why I'm mad or why I distance myself. I never said we was gonna stop being friends. I just put in my mind that I'm not gonna be dumb. Away about that shit, and Max acting like she really don't understand why I'm mad or why I distance myself. I never said we was gonna stop being friends. I just put in my mind that I'm not gonna be dumb.
See, this is topics that make me mad. I mean, first of all, you saying that I'm around somebody that you don't even know what the hell I've been doing because you haven't been around me. You've been around me doing your thing with your people's family or whatever. So I'm supposed to just sit here, not do shit, because C hit me up and want to hang out? Come on, grow up, dude. To me, like, this shit right here is crazy. I mean, beef that happened 5 years ago, I'm the type of nigga that's just like this. If I'm around you, I'm not finna talk about you to the next person that I know you ain't fucking with. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna keep a neutral party. I'm gonna be biased. So for her to think that, you know what I'm saying, that I would go around C and just tell her business for what? That don't have nothing to do with me. It don't gain me anything. You know what I'm saying? What you tell me is what you tell me. Especially if ain't nothing that's gonna put no money in my pocket. Like, come on, man. You for real? Before I allow myself to get set up like that, I'm not going to allow it. I'm just not going to allow it. Like, you can, Max want me to put all my trust in her, but you can't trust humans. You can't put no trust, you can't put 100% of your trust in not now human that walked this earth. And I'm not going to do it. You telling me that you're not going to spread my business, and you're not going to do this, if you get mad, all this bullshit. I can't trust that. Come on, you talking to my number one enemy. My number one enemy. And you want me to trust you with my personal business. It ain't gonna happen, Calvin. It ain't happening. I mean, I ain't gonna lie for some type of way. It is what it is. Like, I'm not even gonna lie to you. Like, I look at Kels in a whole different light. I mean, to me, when I'm your friend, I'm your friend. Cut from a whole different type of cloth. So if you don't trust me, you know what I'm saying, then you dip. Cause I know that I'm better than that. I ain't on no fuck nigga shit. Believe that.
Hello? Yo, what's up?
Oh my God, man, what happened?
What happened about what? What you mean?
Something happened to C, man. I don't know. I'm getting hit all kind of shit, man. I don't know. All I know is she in the hospital. Man, I thought she was with you.
She wasn't with me last night. What the fuck you mean what happened to her? I mean, last time I talked to her, she wouldn't even answer the phone. I was trying to get with her last night. So what happened? Like, you know nothing?
Sometimes people can hear people and then leave and run like that. And they know. Hit you that hard, you in the air, they just took off.
This shit is 5 years old. Why is this like to bring up the situation? I think it's an issue that maybe y'all need to talk about.
I don't want to talk. If I told her, I'd probably slap the shit out of her.
I want to make it official. I love her. I'm going to propose to her. She said yes. We're going to do it. She said no. I'm selling this bitch on eBay.
See, we broke up. I was cheating, so I didn't give a fuck.
You know why I don't come out with you? Because every time I come out with you, I don't get none of your attention.
But
none
of that.
But at the end of the day, it's so what? I don't come out with you at all.